Hi guys, Squirrel here, I'm back with some Hunter. I thought we'd just go for a roam today and just see what we can find. I've got a 300 bolt action sniper rifle with a scope, it's a zoomable scope. I've also got my 44 revolver, and I've spotted a deer stand just nearby, so I thought I'd just pitch up on the deer stand, have a look around. We'll take it from there. I don't know what we're going to find today, I'm just going to go hunting and tracking and see what happens. Where is this place? Oh, here it is. I knew it was over here somewhere. I think we're almost at the peak now. I'm walking around with my revolver. I'm thinking to myself, you never know. You might get jumped on by a bear. Look at these rocks. Floaty rocks. You might get jumped on by a bear or something. So I'm just kind of walking around with a... wow, that is bad. Oh, here it is. Right, okay. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get on top of this thing and just have a scout around. Maybe we'll see something. Unlikely, but it's worth a try. Looks fairly clear anyway. God, he just so reminds me of DayZ. Whenever I see these deer stands, I'm like, DayZ, you know, because, well, in the early days of DayZ, that was... used to come across these things all the time, use them as little waypoints and stuff. How do I get up this thing? Oh, yeah. Press E, I think. Yeah, you press the E key. All right, well, wow, what a view. Blimey. Look at that. That's not what I want to do. Stand up, that's better. I was hoping I could just kind of crouch and get a good shot. Did I just hear something? Was that my foot? No, I definitely just heard something. Hello? Oh my god. Headshot. Oh! Wow. I can't believe that. I climb up a deer stand. That's insane. Bear in mind, I came up the other side of that hill and I was already walking quite slowly, so this thing obviously didn't hear me. But I'll take that. I've not even been out here 5 minutes. Yep, that's dead alright. Let's take a quick photo. I know we can take trophy photos, but you often can't get a good angle. Nice. I reckon that wasn't actually a headshot, but it's a pretty clean wound, I think. Let's ID it. Oh wow, look at that. Flippin' heck. Wound time. Wound time 0. Harvest value 100. I hit it like right in the spine, like the top of the spine, just between the spine and the cranium. Like, it instantly killed it. 100 points isn't that great, but... I'd say that was maximum harvest value. That was perfect. It killed it with... like, there was just nothing. Just, boom, dead. Roaming turkey, anyone? Well, I suppose it is near Christmas. Do we go back up there and have a look around? Yeah, let's quickly get back up here. The thing is, I reckon that shot... probably anywhere within half a mile to a mile, probably everything just runs. Maybe even further. I don't know how the game mechanics work exactly. I should probably read on the wiki at some point. But maybe along that ridge line there. Heavy breathing simulator. That's not me, by the way. Whenever you scope in, your character always goes... That's so weird. I'm not even holding my breath. Like, you press space and it'll steady your shot. Can't see anything. Just looking for any signs of movement. Maybe that's too far. I think there's a draw distance limit. I don't know what the limit is, though. But beyond a certain distance, you know, even if there are animals, it's not going to show them. Yeah, I should probably just move from here, go for a wander. Wow, look at that out there. That's pretty good draw distance, blimey. Alright, let's move out of here, let's move on. I'm thinking we should probably head for that peak over there. I don't want to go all the way over to that hut, but if we go to the peak and then, I don't know, walk down the side of it, maybe we'll get a good view up there. I like views, as you know. Let's head towards the ridge on the... should we go through the woods or over the ridge? I need to go up there. The peak's actually on that hill, so... let's mosey on down this way, see if we can see any tracks on the way. There's actually a little track down there, look. Let's go and ID it. There's one here too, look. Abandoned current, yep. Turkey, boring. I'm not going shooting turkey. Aha! Elk. The thing is, that's probably going to be the elk that we just shot. Like, it was probably in this area when we started. So, yeah, look, he kind of headed that way. So that's most... I reckon that's the elk we shot already. Let's ignore that. I'll tell you what, the graphics in this game are lovely. It really does feel like you're walking around the wilderness. Kind of reminds me of the fishing game. Hello? Ooh, some deer. You can see on the little mini tool we've got there, can you see it? It kind of pinpoints the rough area that the noise came from. It's down that way, but I'd kind of like to go to the peak, but... I can't ignore those sounds, you know? Let's have a quick look over this hill, down the ridge. See if it looks like they're in a spot where you could... because, I mean, if it's surrounded in trees, it's just not worth it, but... if there's some open areas, then maybe it's worth going down there rather than going to the peak. Actually looks very, very forestry. Very woody. I don't want to go too far down. The good thing about walking around rather than sprinting is that, you know, if there is anything nearby, then you won't frighten it. I think the sounds are down that, right down there somewhere. Which doesn't look like an easy spot to hunt on, to be honest. So I'm kind of tempted to ignore that one. And make our way back up to the peak here and have a look at the peak. There it is again, though. It's actually back that way. Despite what I'm just saying, I'm like, I can't ignore it. I can't ignore the noise. Must go and hunt things. It's a strange noise they make, isn't it? I just think there's so many trees that at ground level, you wouldn't be able to spot them. You need to be elevated like this just to even have a chance of it. Yeah. Let's go back to the peak. Actually just up this hill. Actually closer than I thought. I'm still looking. I'm hoping that I'll happen upon some wild animal and I'll be able to have a pistol fight with it. Or maybe even one day I'll get jumped on by a bear or something. It'll be like revolver in a bear. Man versus bear. Or rather squirrel versus bear. Could be quite funny. This actually isn't a... wow, what is this? It's just a viewing platform. It's not exactly a place to hunt. It is just a viewing platform, I think, but there's nothing to stop you. There's no reason why you couldn't shoot from here, but I think you're better off just using it as a... perhaps a place to navigate, you know? Plan your route and go, oh, look down there, we'll go that way, we'll go this way, but... what a view. That really is heavily forested down there. That's a river running through as well. Let's have a quick scan. Don't see any movement at all. That's not my breathing. Don't think there's anything. What on earth was that? Elk. Elk sounds quite different to the deer, doesn't it? Where is that? Down the hill there. See, that bit there with the hill, that's got a lot of trees missing. Which means if I could spot some... What the heck? Freaky camera. If I get too close to that, it looks upwards. If I can spot something here, that's open enough to shoot it. Why is she still heavy breathing? She's lying down with a rifle. She should be really calm at this point, not breathing like this. This is crazy. It's very hard to spot through the trees, though. Unless they walk out into the open. I'm not really going to get a clear shot from here. Let's leave this place, as fun as it was. It's not really very productive. Let's go down the hill. Let's go for a wander and try and find some tracks. This revolver, so cool. Look at this. Ooh. More deer. That's a good sign. If we go towards that direction, then we should be able to start... We should be able to start picking up some tracks. I think that was just some background noise, that rattling. So let's head that way. Look at this view. I mean, just look at that. That looks so good. Not much luck up here. I'm thinking about going down that way towards the water or something. Just not even had a track up here. Despite that noise, just it's been so quiet. Look at that. It's like a Bob Ross painting. It really is. Happy little trees. Just track it down here. Maybe we're just too high up, I don't know. Maybe we'll have more joy down here in the woods. This is kind of where animals live. It's very green down here. Lots of trees, lots of places for people to hide, animals to hide and jump on you. So yeah. Hello? Did I just... Hello? Are you kidding me? Oh. Are you dead? I think so. I'm pretty certain I just saw one run off out the corner of my eye. I might have imagined that. I was too busy trying to find out if that one was dead. I didn't go for the head this time. I thought I'd go for the kind of chest area. Let's get down there. There you are. You beauty. Let's ID that. Or maybe we'll have a little quick photo. That angle. Back a bit. There you go. Zoom in a touch. Another one for the Hunter's photo album. That's a bit naff. I think that's... Yeah, that's nice. That's a good angle. All right, let's see what happened. Let's ID you. What do we get? Wound time 0, 100% yield, harvest value 100. Instant kill again. Weight 200 odd kilos. It's an elk. That's really good. Instant kill. I was always going for the chest. If you look, I actually smashed it right through the neck, which just instantly dropped it. Unbelievable. So yeah, the harvest value is maximum for that, because it's just instant to kill with a very small wound. That's perfect. Number two, two neck bones. Look at that, neck bone 2 and 3. That's amazing. Let's get a trophy shot. So a trophy shot is where you get to stand next to it, which would be cool. Another one for the album. There we go. Nice. We'll take that. Let's just continue the hunt. Maybe go for one more. So you have a look at the map where we are. I might head towards that there. My head towards that little campfire thingy. Make that the final destination. See if we can pick up another one on the way. There are some tracks here by the look of it, but I guess I'm just thinking they're the tracks from the... Yeah, they probably are just the elk. Either other elk that scattered or that one. But either way, they won't be here anymore. It's pointless looking for them. Let's head that way. I think it's on the other side of the peak. Yeah, you can see the on the other side of that hill is the little campfire thingy. Just wondering if there's anything on the side of that hill there. You never know. Nope. Let's carry on. Oh wow, look at that. That's pretty cool. More tracks. And they actually point towards the water. It could be that one of them ran off this way. Let's have a quick look. So before we go down there. I don't see anything. Just looking for any sign of movement, really. Did I see something in there? Or was that my... No, I did. I did see something. Oh, wow. Let's crouch. Lie down. Get more stability. Get this stupid grass out of the way. I hope I've not lost sight of it. I think it was just about... No, where are you? Move, move so I can see you. I don't want to look somewhere else. I'm pretty certain it was about here. There it is, there it is, there it is. Uh-oh, it's on the move. It's... Stop, 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 stop. Oh, man. I don't even know if I hit that. I can't see it anymore. There's too many trees. I don't know why it suddenly started jogging. Now the problem is trying to get down there. So I need those two trees there. It's the base of that tree. One thing I've learned about playing this game is when you've shot something, always take a moment to kind of look at the position of where you think it went. Because when you get down there, it will look nothing like this. So, that tree there, just to the right of the one with the really gnarly roots, that's the gnarly roots. It was about that area that I shot it. So, if it's not... If I hit it, it would drop nearby. If I missed it, it's gone. But I think the best thing to do now is to get down to that tree. And... Look for a body or even a trail, because if we hit it, it might have just wounded it. In which case, we can pick up the trail and go for and try and find it and kill it. This is an awesome little pocket of water here. I bet this is actually quite popular with animals. I bet they come here for a drink. So this would be a pretty good hunting spot, I reckon. Not really sure if I should slow walk this or just sprint over. Because I don't know if the animal's dead. That's the thing. It may have just fled a bit and then be on top of that hill or something. You know what, let's just run. The longer I leave it, the worse it's going to get. Because if I have wounded it, then the trail's going to start to go off, isn't it? So let's just run over. See if we can find it. Oh, oh yes, oh yes! So this will be, yep, so trotting, that's where it started to run. So it started to jog here, I reckon I shot at it about here. Fleeing, right, okay. So it ran this way. Not that, that's a different trail. Where do you go, where do you go? Is that it? Fleeing still, yep. Ooh, you went over the road, look. So the kind of bigger circles mean that's your current, that's a track for you. Oh, look at blood. Blood. I hit it. All my life I hit it, fleeing. It's wounded. The bigger circles mean it's the same track that you're currently looking at. You can only track one thing at a time. Whereas the very small semicircles mean that's a different track. There's every chance that this thing has died. And even if it hasn't, we've got a very strong trail. Look, there's more blood. Or something on the floor, you see it? Like little drops of blood on the way. This is awesome. Again, I don't know whether to sprint or not, because if it's wounded, I walk slow, then we might be able to creep up on it. But if it's dead, I might as well sprint. But I don't know if it's dead yet. Still fleeing. Another one. How many more? How far did it go? Flipping heck. This thing would have bled out by now. Uh-oh, I think I've lost it. Oh no, there it is. That next one? Can I see a body next to it? That next one, you see it there? This could be it, you know. Oh, yes. Oh, hello. You didn't make it, pal. Sorry about that. You didn't make it. That was a bad shot. Yeah, zero harvest value. Oh, my life. Look at that. 3 minutes 42 wound time. That's not good. Trophy integrity. Intestine. Ouch. Okay, I think I've learned something here. Because the harvest value is zero. That was quite a long wound. That's I don't think that's good. I think next time it's moving, I'm not going to take the shot. I'm going to wait till it's still and get a good clean kill. The first two kills were really good. That one, I don't think that was a good kill for me. But we'll take a photo anyway. Let's play around these camera settings. Press F to toggle help. WASD. Oh, I see. So we can zoom in with page up and page down. 0 to 9 switch. Can we put a weapon? Oh, nice. You can put the weapon in your hand. I've never played with the camera settings. This is pretty cool. We'll get one for the photo album, even though it wasn't a clean kill. We did some pretty good job tracking it down. Let's get a nice angle. Zoom out a touch. Maybe about there. Yay! Nice. All right, I think that's pretty good. Let's head over to the... Yeah, it disappears. Let's head over to that little spot. We're very, very close to it now. That's like a camping spot, so I can safely quit there. I think if we get to it... I'm not sure if I've been to it before, but if we get over to it now, then... I think if it's a visitation place, then you visited it, you can fast travel to it later, I think. Maybe you can do it anyway, but it's a cost. Not exactly sure how it all works. I know you can get tents, you can buy tents in the store and put a tent down, it lets you fast travel to it. But I think the thing about a tent as well is when you visit it, you can then get stuff out of your inventory. Because when you go out hunting, you can only take a certain amount of things with you. And obviously, if you run out of rounds or you want to change weapon, then you need to go back to a campsite. And I think the tent is a campsite, but you have to buy them from the store. Remember, this is a free-to-play game, so pretty much everything you're going to have to pay for. But this, I don't know. I don't know what this bit's about. I don't know if you can camp here. I don't know if you can change equipment here. I'm not really sure about it, to be honest. Let's go and have a quick look at it. Well, yeah, that's not bad, is it? 3. I've only fired, like, 3 rounds as well and killed 3 things. 2 perfectly good kills. Well, to be fair, the first one was an easy kill. Hello? What's with the music? Is that must be some kind of discovery music. Look at this. Boxes and barrels and oh man. You could sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat round here. Look at this. What a cracking view. Another Bob Ross special. Let's see how I did. This was the outing here. Let's have a look. Settler Creeks. There's my weapon, ammunition. Look at that. 3 shots. 100% kill accuracy with 3 confirmed kills. That's quite a long shot, actually. Nice. We've got a couple of achievements. One for walking and one for killing that particular elk. They're the 3 kills. And actually, look at this. It's brilliant the way it all breaks it all down. It shows you where you killed them, you know, how you hit them, the harvest value, the weapons that you used. Of course, if you use the right weapon, you get more points for it. Pretty good outing. Anyway, that's it from me, guys. Don't forget to give me a like if you enjoyed that. Leave me some comments. Let me know if you'd like me to hunt anything in particular. Until next time, happy hunting.